In this tutorial, I will be introducing Flask SQL Alchemy. In most of the web applications we develop, we will need to connect to a database. So SQL Alchemy provides you a mechanism to read, write, update, and delete from the database using Python code. So here I will be installing SQLite 3, which is the database I'm using in this demo. Now we have to install the Flask SQL Alchemy package. Here you can see there are a number of packages with the name Flask SQL Alchemy. If you examine the bottom of the screen, you can see the progress of the installation. Now let's begin by importing the SQL Alchemy class. Once you have this, you need to specify the location of the database. Since I'm using SQLite 3, I'll be specifying the location of the database. You may use other databases such as MySQL, Postgres. If you are using MySQL or Postgres, you would have to specify the database name, username, and password in the connection string. Now I'm creating an object of the class SQL Alchemy, and I'm also passing the variable app. Now let's start by creating a new Python file. I will be naming it as models.py. I want to create a table in my database with the name user. For that, I would have to create a class user. And the table is supposed to have three fields: ID, username, and email. And the ID is an integer field, and it is the primary key. Then I also want the ID to be auto-incremented, so the user does not have to supply the value of the ID. You can copy this portion from the ID and paste it in the over here. The username is supposed to be a string field, and you cannot have more than one primary key. So I am renaming it to unique key, and I don't want it to be auto-incremented. Then I am expecting the username to be having maximum of 20 characters, and this field cannot be null. Now let's create the third field. It can have a characters of 80. And now let's create the dunder wrapper function. Most of you might not be familiar with the dunder wrapper function. I will be explaining the dunder wrapper function with an example. I'm going to create a class fruit. Let's create a variable name and initialize it with the null string. The dunder wrapper function will return the value of the variable name. Let's create an object of the class Apple. I'm initializing the value of the variable name. Now let's check the output when I am trying to print the object Apple. It is printing Apple. What if the dunder wrapper function is not there? The program will print the default value of the object. The dunder wrapper function provides a mechanism to change the default value of an object. Now we will create a Python file for demonstrating the create operation. This is basically equivalent to the insert statement in SQL. We need to import the DB object as well as the user class. So we import the DB object from the main.py and the user class from models.py. db.create all will create the database for you. Now let's create two objects of the class user. So I'm going to create admin and guest user. We need to supply two arguments that are the username and email. I can simply copy paste the same and do the modifications. Now you have two objects of the class user. Now we need to add this to the database. So we will be using db.session.add, name of the object. Now db.session.add guest. We haven't finished. We need to call the commit method to finish the execution. Now let's check whether these operations were performed on the database. You can see that pkg.db has appeared. .tables will show you the existing tables in the SQLite3 database. I have issued a normal select query and you can see the output. Next, we will see the read operation. That is typically the select query. I'm going to create a new Python file and I am copying the first two lines
I have renamed the previous file to user create. So if you want to fetch all the rows from a table, you can use user.query.all. We got this output because we are using the dunder wrapper function. Otherwise, you will be seeing the default values. Now I have assigned the values to a users variable, and I will be iterating through each of these variables and printing the email. Next, we will see a filter operation. That is, if you need to specify a specific condition. This is equal to conditional cell queries. In such queries, we will be specifying a condition using the where clause, select star from table where condition. So here, by using the filter by method, we can specify the condition. Next part is the update operation. I am creating a new Python file, tableupdate.py. And I'm copying this line to my new file. Let's rename this variable selected user. So I have got the object to be modified. The current email of the object is guest@tutorialsfromscratch.com. I am modifying it to guest100@tutorialsfromscratch.com. Committing the operation. Now let's issue an SQL query. Next operation that we are going to see is the delete operation. I am copying the entire content from the tableupdate.py. We won't be needing this line. The delete operation can be performed by calling the method delete, and you have to give the object as the argument to the method. We can examine the output by executing the cell query. You can see the previous result. You can see we have seen how to use Flask SQL Alchemy. We have performed create, update, delete, and read operations from the database.